Hello friends, welcome again. I know you have waited a lot, but the wait is finally over. Here is my second book review. This is the book, 10 Judgments That Changed India. This is the most important book to be read by every budding lawyer. This book is written by Zia Modi, who is a well-known corporate lawyer. And interestingly, she is the daughter of renowned jurist Sori Sorabji. This book talks about 10 most important landmark judgments which changed the fate of entire India. So stay tuned. So before starting with the review of this book, I would like to tell you the best thing about this book. You all must have heard the Keswanand Bhati was a state of Kerala judgment. This judgment is 800 pages long judgment, but this book has explained it well just in 20 to 30 pages. So I really appreciate that feature of this book. So the first judgment in this book is none other than Keswanand Bharti vs. State of Kerala. It is the 800 pages long judgment, as I have already mentioned earlier. It is the unique judgment in the international constitutional history. So there are basic issues which can be observed in the case. Whether the basic structure doctrine can be changed? Can the court review the amendment violating the fundamental rights? And what are the basic facts of this case? The Kerala Land Reforms Act 1963 had affected the property of the Swami Keswanand's religious institutional rights. And what are the findings of this case? Basic structure cannot be amended. Amendment violating the fundamental rights is subject to the review of the court. And how this case changed the fate of India. It protected India in many forms. Indian state was saved from being collapsed. Supreme Court chose uncertain democracy over certain tyranny. Judiciary is regarded as the custodian of the constitution. Keswanand Bhati case is a safety valve to preserve the Indian democracy. And these are the lines of the book. So, the second judgment. Menaka Gandhi vs. Union of India. This case is the best case with respect to Article 21, that is right to life. So let me tell you the brief facts of this case. Government of India impounded the passport of Menaka Gandhi. When asked the reason for impounding, the authorities refused to specify, and hence the petition was filed. So the central issue was, does the Passport Act satisfy due process of law and requirements of Article 21? And at this juncture, meaning of right to life has been expanded. For example, right to privacy, as of now, the judgment was revolving around Article 21. Now, Article 21 has got a vast dimension for the very first time. It has long-lasting impact even today. This is how India's fate has been changed by this judgment. So the third judgment of this book is Muhammad Ahmad Khan vs. Shahbano Begum. This case brought a flood-like situation in India. It had shaken the government of that time. So what are the brief facts of this case? A Muslim husband divorced his wife and the dispute arose on account of maintenance. So the central issue was, can a religious law override central law? And after the judgment was delivered, there was a wide outrage in the entire country. However, the Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 1986 was enacted to ensure the protection of Muslim women. How this case changed India? The outrage occurred at that time was highly devastating. However, the impact of this case can be seen in the latest case of Shaira Banu Begum. This is the landmark judgment ensuring the Muslim women's rights or the women's rights in general. So here comes the fourth judgment, Olga Tellis vs. Bombay Municipal Corporation. This is the important judgment on second generational rights such as housing. So the brief facts. Slum and pavement dwellers who came in Mumbai in search of jobs were living in informal settlements. they were evicted on CM orders, and hence this petition was filed. So the central issue was with respect to Article 21. However, now the contention was the Article 21 must include the second generational rights such as housing, as I have already mentioned earlier. So what was the result of this case? Right to life include the right to livelihood. This was the judgment. This was the line in the judgment. And how this judgment changed India. Right of housing was recognized as fundamental right. This judgment gave a stern message that the court will not be a silent spectator over the violation of the human rights of its citizens. Now, coming to the fifth case. Union Carbide Corporation versus Union of India. This is the Bhopal gas tragedy. This is a case which has left its deep scar until now. It was indeed a tragedy. A brief facts. A chemical component, methyl isocyanate, was leaked from a gas plant in Bhopal. It severely injured the people of Bhopal. This case has left a deep scar on the country, but so far we have recovered from it. Now the sixth judgment. This is a famous case on the topic of reservation. Indra Sahani versus Union of India. The central issue was whether 50% can be exceeded, 50% of reservation. So the decision was, it was a landmark ruling that 50% reservation cannot be exceeded. The policy was found to be unconstitutional, and hence the rule is followed now as well. In all of the cases, wherever the policy was framed, where the Supreme Court felt that the reservation is exceeded above 50%, so it struck down as unconstitutional. So this is how the impact of the judgment is. The seventh judgment. Now this is a very landmark ruling on custodial debts. Neelabati Behera versus State of Orissa. So the central issue was, can the police administration be controlled? Can this custodial violence be stopped? Because even the criminals are humans. And how this decision changed India? Certain guidelines were framed by Supreme Court. These guidelines are now authority. This judgment also made it explicitly clear that even the criminals are humans. Hence, they can't be treated like beasts. They also have right to life under Article 21. So this is how the impact this judgment made at that time. This is the landmark ruling on custodial debts in India. Now the eighth judgment, that is Supreme Court Advocates on Record Association versus Union of India. This judgment established the independence of judiciary. This case pertains to the appointment of the Supreme Court and High Court judges and other related issues. Now there is a collegium system which ensures the independence of judiciary, which was not the case earlier. So hence, the Supreme Court Advocates on Record Association versus Union of India changed India in this way. Now the ninth judgment. This case is another landmark ruling which encircles the issue of dignity of women and right of working. Vishakha versus State of Rajasthan. This judgment for the very first time brought a special enactment regarding sexual harassment. This act is successful in protecting the rights and dignity of women. Now it is the obligation of every public and private office to abide by the rules of sexual harassment at workplace. How this judgment changed India? Now every woman has the right to work with dignity, and she is protected from danger of all kinds, and she has been granted that right now. That right, she has the right to work with dignity and free from all kinds of fears. Now the last judgment in this book. It is Aruna Ramchandra Shanbhag versus Union of India. This is one of the most debated case around the issue involving euthanasia. Euthanasia, this topic was discussed so extensively for the very first time in India. and the central issue of this case was, does right to life include right to die? So while reading this case, I realized that the humanity still survives. Miss Aruna Ramchandra Shanbhag's care was taken by the hospital nurses for a very long time, till her death. She was being treated with dignity. The nurses were happily carrying on their service towards her. So in this case, Supreme Court finally came up with the guidelines regarding the administering of euthanasia. However, it also demarcated all the boundaries regarding the administration of euthanasia. So the decision regarding euthanasia will be taken with due care, that whether it is a case where it is necessary to be administered. If it is not, then obviously nobody can just go to the hospital and tell this hospital authorities that yes, I want to die, I'm done with my life and all. So yes, this cannot be done, obviously. So Supreme Court has framed certain guidelines that if the case comes within these guidelines, then only that person can be administered with euthanasia. So that is all about this book. I would highly suggest all of you to read this book. This is the must read book for every budding lawyer. So if you like this video, hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed my channel, then please subscribe. And if you have found this book or found this video useful, then please share it with your friends. And yes, remember, if you want to be a good lawyer, keep growing and keep growing and always keep growing. Thank you so much.